Hi, welcome to Robojax. In this video I'm going to show you how you can use this 5 volts relay module for Arduino. So you can connect a control, a light, like this. This is the relay, the physical dimension, as you can see it here. We have 3 connections here that can be connected to Arduino for control and power purpose. We have 3 terminals here. This one, the middle one, is positive, the other side is negative. If you can see it here, they labeled it as negative. And then the last one is signal. Ground, the middle one is positive, which will be connected to 5 volts. This will be connected to the power of Arduino. And this is the signal where it receives the signal to turn this on. Now we have an LED here whenever it receives a signal to energize the relay to establish the connection. This will turn on, indicating that there is signal. On this side, we have 3 terminals here, and this is normally connected. What it means is that if you connect 2 wires like that, these 2 will be connected. If you connect 2 wires here, these are normally open and they will be connected like that when the power establishes or the signal comes. Whatever you do, this pin, the middle one, will never change. So keep the wire, the middle wire here. If you don't know what is the condition of the relay, under what condition it's on and off, so keep the middle not changed, just change the other wire here or there, and then you will find your way. Another thing that to remember about this relay is that it can handle up to 10 ampere in any voltage. Here it says 30 volts, 10 ampere. If you're using 30 volts or 28 volts, that's 10 ampere. But if you are, let's say, in North America, you're using 120 volts, so that's 10 ampere. So what you do is multiply by 10, just put a 0 here. This can handle in North America 1250 watt 1.25 kilowatt machine to turn on and off. If you're in Europe or Asia or somewhere else which has 220 or 240 volts, so then it will be 2500 watts. So remember that, that's the limitation, because if you connect a load that is heavier or it needs more current, this will melt down or it will not work. Consider that limitation when you're using it. Another thing to remember about this one is that this is not optically isolated, so it doesn't have optocoupler, which means the relay is connected to the rest of the circuit, except these 3 contacts are isolated totally. Keep in mind that when you're working with AC voltage, you have to be very careful. You have to wear a protective glove if you're trying to touch this area once it's connected or the power is connected. And make sure that you do not put this in a metallic surface. Let me explain the AC bulb. So this is a table light that is connected to the wall outlet, and then the wire goes and will be turned on. But I have disconnected one of these 2 wires here. I've just cut this wire from here. Now this can be connected to the relay. The relay job is to just connect it, so it will be on, and disconnected will be off. I've just twisted them and then put some solder, so this can be inserted into a connector with a screw. To connect the wire, just unscrew this here and then insert the wire and then tighten it back. The same thing for the other one. Now I have connected the AC load here between the middle one and this side. This is normally open, so when the relay gets power or gets the signal, it will connect these 2 wires to turn on the bulb. Pin is connected to pin 7, and then the red is connected to 5 volts, and then ground is connected to the ground of Arduino. Let me explain the code. The setup, we have just set this pin mode, setting pin 7 as output. So this will be connected to terminal S, or the signal of Arduino. And the setup, we don't do anything. And inside the loop, we say that when it initially starts, pin 7 should be high. This is turning the relay on and then keeping it for 3000 milliseconds or 3 seconds. And after that, it turns it off and keeps it off for 5000 milliseconds. So this is as simple as that. You can do whatever you want under your condition or control, controlling some heater, or maybe the relay should be turned on and off under certain condition. Let's say a temperature increases, or you're turning on and off some fan or other equipment. So you can do it here. Just control the pin 7 to be high or low under certain condition. For example, this push is the value of a push button that you're receiving it. When somebody pushes a button or the value is high, if you say if push is equal high, then turn this on and keep it for 3000 milliseconds on. Or you can just remove this and just say turn it on, just put this line. Now the AC load is also connected. Everything is connected except the Arduino. Arduino don't have any power yet. There is AC now there. As you can see, normally open means when the system doesn't have any signal or any power, it's open, not connected. But it goes for 3 seconds on and 5 seconds off. You can get the code by clicking at the link in the description below, or you can go directly to robojax.com/learn/arduino. Thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video if you like it. Please subscribe and also share this video. I appreciate it.